Welcome to News Today with WDW News Today. I'm Tom Corliss. Here now the news for November 15th, 2019. The ongoing construction to enhance Disney's transportation and ticket center near the Magic Kingdom has seen several notable changes this month. Several large sections of new concrete have been poured behind construction walls. A new planter wall that encompasses one of the monorail track supports has also been erected. Workers were hard at work installing new potable water lines under trenches dug in the dirt. And as we look toward the newly installed roofing over the new security screening area, we can see new concrete has been poured underneath these as well. Behind them, rebar can be seen ready to be installed. And across the water on one of the islands in the Seven Seas Lagoon, workers were seen mowing and trimming some of the foliage even. This, of course, could be in preparation for the fireworks displays that are shot from the lake's islands during New Year's Eve, which is quickly approaching. The ongoing construction on the Magic Kingdom arrival experience is continuing as well. New construction equipment continues to flow into the staging and storage areas just east of the Magic Kingdom bus loop. The former dock site for the resort's boats is completely devoid of anything green as construction equipment has taken over the site. New pipes and various electrical and water lines are being laid into place throughout the area. And from the monorail station, green scrims obscure the work going on behind the pathway and boat dock areas. Over by the security screening area, work continues on the structure that will cover the future security checkpoint for boat and bus arriving guests. Well, it looks like two matching round planters are being prepared behind their respective green construction walls. The planter on the east side looks further along than the one on the west side. These planters may mirror those for the large southern live oak trees just past the turnstiles in front of the Main Street station. From across the water, you can see that work continues on the resort boat dock area as several vehicles are on site. Lots of construction today. Among the plethora of construction projects underway at Epcot currently, it's often hard to see progress. And over at the proposed site for the Moana Journey of Water walkthrough attraction, you would say we've seen some concrete advancement. It's a pun, folks. Last week we checked. A set of concrete frames had been installed along the area. Now there are full sets of concrete slabs laid out along them. Considering that Moana Journey of Water will also inhabit some of the space that is currently taken up by those Interventions West buildings in the background, find it hard to believe that this quickly forming concrete work is actually for said attraction. This is just a theory, but it appears that this is a new walkway to detour guests while work continues on the entrance of the park, the center of Future World, and eventually on the Spaceship Earth refurbishment and overhaul next year. The walkway would lead out over to the Seas Pavilion right down to where the new temporary character spot location is, possibly bypassing all of the construction as a temporary way to get in the park from the entrance. To clarify, we've not heard that this is happening, but something awfully suspicious looks to be taking place in this area. Rumors, of course, also persist that Interventions West will be the temporary home of Guest Relations and Mouse Gear when work commences on remodeling those locations in the near future. Additional portions of concrete have yet to be poured and set in the area, but the framework is being laid out, as you'll see in the photos. Off to the left side, an inner fenced-in walkway is still being used as a backstage area for cast members, but a new walkway, clearly intended for guests, is coming into shape. This reminds me a lot of when they were overhauling California Adventure on the West Coast. They set up a temporary park entrance while they redid the park entrance there, while they built Buena Vista Street and built new turnstiles. So maybe something similar is happening at Epcot. Not quite at the turnstiles, but a little after that with the fountain work and Spaceship Earth, and then moving towards the back where they'll have the new World Celebration area and Dreamers Point and all of those things. Santa Claus has been spotted on Sunset Boulevard at Hollywood Studios. The back of Once Upon a Time souvenir shop has been transformed once again into a Christmas haven with a big comfy couch waiting for you and your kiddos to meet Santa. Santa meets guests intermittently throughout the day, about every other hour. Wait times vary from half an hour to over an hour sometimes, with breaks in between. Santa, of course, has to take breaks to feed his reindeer. Just go with it. The line is set up in between Once Upon a Time and Beauty and the Beast live on stage, so there's no need to walk around the shop in confusion. The setup is rather nice, the ideal location if you're looking for the perfect place for this year's Christmas card photos. And of course, PhotoPass photographers are stationed here as well. No photo boxes. This 1930s-inspired meet-and-greet location, first debuted back in 2016, has been going strong ever since. Originally set to reopen on November 24th, it has been announced that Primeval World and Dinoland USA at the Animal Kingdom will now reopen on November 23rd, a full day earlier. That's right, something's going to open earlier, folks. How often does that happen? Attraction will open for morning extra magic hours. What a way to start your day. For resort guests from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m., then opening to the general public through 8 p.m. that day. The ride is set to resume seasonal operation on the 24th and will only be open until December 1st, open to handle higher crowds at the park due to the Thanksgiving holiday. Of course, we do expect it will reopen for Christmas week, but that has not been announced quite yet. In celebration of the new Disney Skyliner transportation system, a Funko Pop figure inspired by the Skyliner will be available beginning November 16th. This collectible Funko Pop figure will be available at World Traveler at Epcot, Mickey's of Hollywood at Disney's Hollywood Studios, Disney's Pop Century Resort, the Art of Animation Resort, Caribbean Beach Resort, and Disney's Boardwalk. Merchandise will also be available at the new Disney's Riviera Resort when it opens later this year. It's next month, in fact. Things are getting sweet over at Disney's Boardwalk Inn. One of the highlights of the holiday season at Walt Disney World is the gingerbread displays that appear throughout the resorts, such as Contemporary, Grand Floridian Yacht Club, and Wilderness Lodge, videos and photos of all of which are on our YouTube channel and on our site. But yesterday, the miniature gingerbread version of Disney's Boardwalk opened for guests viewing pleasure. The display can be found in the resort's lobby, directly across from the front desk. There's a wedding gazebo complete with a carriage and two white stallions. For sports fans, the ESPN Club is represented, including the unique and recognizable hand and dumbbell that sits atop the building. Or even if you don't like sports, you just like those chicken dingers, you can enjoy that one. The Boardwalk Bakery is the centerpiece of the display, with Mickey and Minnie busy in the kitchen whipping up heaps of tiny holiday treats. And the Boardwalk's most prominent restaurant also makes an appearance. A sign nearby also lists how much of each ingredient went into making the display. And across from the gingerbread display, guests can purchase an array of pre-wrapped yummy sweets. And at Dundee's Sundries, there's merchandise available to commemorate the display. You can visit wdwnt.com for a full video of the Boardwalk Inn's gingerbread display. Coronado Springs and the Grandestino Tower have decked their halls in anticipation of the holiday season. The entrance to Coronado Springs is done up with a beautiful flowered garland welcoming guests into the lobby. Small trees covered in ornaments and lights can be found scattered around that area. Giant wreaths can be found hanging around the check-in desks. Garland can be found draped across Ponchitos and outside Villa del Lago. And over at the brand new Grandestino Tower, they've put up decorations and a magnificent Christmas tree for their first holiday season, and that's in their lobby. The tree is breathtaking, but in sort of a weird place due to the columns framing it to the sides and the position of furniture nearby, but they'll figure it out. It's first Christmas. Ron John's Surf Shop at Disney Springs has opened a day early. Things are opening early, how about this? The 10,000 square foot store, which marks Ron John's Surf Shop's 12th location in the United States, is in the town center area. Ron John's store employees were excited to welcome their very first guests with complimentary souvenir lays. And as far as the merchandise goes, it's your typical logo, apparel, and surf supplies. Guests looking for sun protection products can find a variety of sun bum sunscreens here as well. Fun memorabilia, such as a signed surfboard of the world's youngest champion surfer, Kelly Slater, are also on display. Upstairs, via staircase or escalator, there's also an elevator, by the way, you'll find some home decor as well as footwear, toys, more apparel, and yes, actual surfboards. For a full tour of the newly opened store, you could look right here on our YouTube channel. Disney has launched a large update to the My Disney Experience app, bringing guests a way to opt into the Service Your Way program through the app itself. Part of this service, guests can decline housekeeping services in exchange for a Disney gift card with amounts varying depending on the length of stay. The gift card will be delivered electronically in exchange for forfeiting regular daily housekeeping services. Previously, guests had to visit the front desk in order to opt into the program. Guests can also opt into the Direct to Room program, which allows guests to bypass the front desk and go right to their room after checking in online. While that service has been available on the app for years now, additional features and a different interface have been introduced at this time. Also, the app saw an update to the landing page for each resort hotel, bringing even more information about the hotel you're staying at. A walkthrough video for the Direct to Room service program has been added to the app to allow guests to better understand how it works. The Indiana Jones Adventure at Disneyland is set to undergo a major overhaul in 2020, just in time for the ride's astonishing 25th anniversary. According to a permit filed with the City of Anaheim, work is set to begin soon on some significant improvements to the ride. The permit describes the scope of the work as, quote, remove and replace show set bridge to include steel structure, rock work, and planks. We'd expect more work to be done on the attraction during this refurbishment. However, the scope of the additional work is not known at this time. Disney has also not added the Indiana Jones Adventure to the Disneyland refurbishment calendar yet, but you can rest assured that rebuilding a bridge would close the ride. So it's going to be down at some point, but stay tuned. We'll let you know when. To make a little extra magic for Disneyland Resort annual pass holders, It's a Small World holiday will be open for APs after Disneyland closes on November 18th to the 22nd. In addition, pass holders can also enjoy a special photo opportunity during this after-hours event. Pass holders must be inside Disneyland Park before closing and have a valid annual pass. Disneyland is scheduled to close at 10 p.m. on November 18th through the 21st and at midnight on November 22nd. If you can't wait to see this beloved holiday overlay, be sure to check out our video right here on our channel. According to Disney, they have already surpassed 10 million subscribers to their Disney Plus streaming platform. 10 million subscribers was a milestone Wall Street analysts saw as an important one for Disney Plus to reach by the end of the year. They did it in a day. According to a study cited by Variety, during the first 24 hours after its official November 12th launch, the Disney Plus mobile app for iOS and Android was downloaded 3.2 million times. Disney Plus users worldwide collectively also spent 1.3 million hours streaming the service in the first 24 hours, more than the total viewing through Amazon Prime Video and Roku apps in the three countries where Disney Plus is available. Content warnings have been added to movies and shows with outdated cultural depictions across the Disney Plus library. Quote, this program is presented as originally created. It may contain outdated cultural depictions, is what you'll see. Subscribers will encounter content warnings on many Disney classics, including Dumbo, The Aristocats, Aladdin, The Jungle Book, and more. Aladdin's way more modern than the rest of those, by the way. Nothing has been edited out or cut from these animated classics, thank you. And the crows still show up in Dumbo. Edgar the Butler still tries to kill a family of cats in the class war played out in The Aristocats. And the Siamese cats still appear in the original Lady and the Tramp. Additional warnings of tobacco use or depictions are also added to episode synopses and descriptions. Similar warnings can be found in many of the older live-action specials from the 50s and 60s, obviously, as people weren't so aware of the dangers of smoking. And as Disney Plus releases further content from even deeper in the vault, content warnings like these will have to persist. The controversial Song of the South live-action musical film from 1946 was not included as part of the Disney Plus content library at launch, despite these warnings on all these other movies. For more information on these stories and more, head on over to wdwnt.com. And if you're enjoying the show, be sure to like this video, subscribe to WDW News Today on YouTube for more great content, and click the bell for notifications. For the worldwide leader in Disney Parks news, this is Tom Corliss saying enjoy the rest of your today and have a great, big, beautiful tomorrow. And now I have to go to the airport. So, yeah. We'll be at Disneyland Paris the next couple days, covering the opening of the new animation celebration in the Studios Park, and as well the beginning of all the Christmas festivities resort-wide. So make sure you stay tuned to social media and the site for coverage of all that great stuff. And see you in a couple days.